Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Thank you, Dr. Asuad. This is my part, and it is the last presentation in this symposium. It is important as the previous presentation, but it is more, I think it's important because I will talk about the killers. I am Dr. Hatem Al-Wahibi. I am emergency resident R3. My topic is about serious pediatric ingestion. In this presentation, I brought two case scenario. In this case scenario, I will talk how to approach these cases. And then I will discuss briefly about their differential diagnosis and how to approach them. Then at the end, I brought a list of common serious medication and common household products. So before starting the presentation, remember this point. This presentation, it's not covering all the serious medication or a household. So just only to brief you and to alarm you regarding this medication. So I will start with case one. 3 years old child who is previously well and brought it by his parent with the ingested multiple medications. In triage, he is drowsy pale and breathing normally. He is hypotensive, bradycardic and hyperglycemic. ECG done for him immediately, and this is his ECG, which show sinus bradycardia with the inverted T wave in the lateral and inferior leads. What is the most differential diagnosis? Sinus brady with the hypotension. So remember, there is a four cardiac medications that can cause this: calcium channel blocker, beta blocker, clonidine, and digoxin. So this patient, child found to ingest only one tablet of ferabamil. Is it important? Is it serious, one tablet of ferabamil? It is, yes, serious. And there is other differential diagnosis. As I mentioned, beta blocker, opioid, organophosphate, ethanol, and clonidine. This medication can present manifested as hypotension and bradycardia. How to approach calcium channel blocker toxicity? So approach the child, any child, with the ABCD approach. And you can add two in the C and D. C you will add for decontamination, and C calling a toxicologist. Decontamination, if the child present within first hour, you can give him charcoal if he is alert, not drowsy in this case. So in this case, charcoal is not recommended. Try to avoid it because there is a risk of aspiration, and also we can complicate the case more in case if he need intubation. About whole bowel irrigation, it is very helpful in slow releasing medication. If there is a child ingested slow releasing medication, whole bowel irrigation, it's helpful. And how you resuscitate a child with a hypotension, start with the IV fluid as normal sick child. Then you can try atropine as asymptomatic bradycardia. And then you have another choice, norepinephrine. The antidote for calcium blocker toxicity is calcium. Calcium, we have two options: calcium chloride and calcium gluconate. We can give a calcium, high dose of calcium gluconate, up to 60 ml of 10% calcium gluconate. And also we can give 10 to 20 ml of 10% calcium chloride. Then if there is no response and the patient is still symptomatic, we can move to the second line, high dose insulin and glucose. We seeing that it's high dose insulin, that mean is 1 unit per kg. It is above the usual dose, 1 unit per kg with the dextrose, 2 to 4 ml of 25% of dextrose. And if still there is no helpful, and you have a facility for a lipid emulsion, I didn't think so you have it in a local health center. But if you work in the secondary hospital, maybe you find it. And glucagon. Glucagon actually is selective for beta blocker toxicity. But if the patient is still having hypotension, we can give a trial of glucagon, 50 microgram. And if it's still the last option we have is transthoracic cardiac basic. During this scenario and how to approach this patient, there is something may help you as a physician or treating physician is calling a toxicologist. He will help you and he will guide you. Second case, two and a half year old child who is previously well, and he brought it by his parent unconscious and responsive. They found him in the garden of the house. His vitals showing here, BB is 90 over 50, heart rate 140, temperature 37.1, respiratory rate 30. Oxygen saturation is 100% at room air. Pupils are constructive and reactive bilaterally. Then child suddenly he sees, start to seize. What happened here? His vitals is the normal. What happened to this child who is previously well? He has no background of seizure or epilepsy. What is missing here? The missing here is very important, is a vital signs in any responsive or comatose patient, is RBS. Please don't forget RBS. This patient, his RBS is 0.4. He received 10 ml of Birkagi of dextrose, 10%, and he respond well and he recover. So this patient, his grandmother found her medication bag in his room, which is containing glipizide, which is a type of sulfonylurea. How to approach a sulfonylurea? Sulfonylurea toxicity is as other toxicity. You have to stabilize the patient by ABCD approach, and you have to give them dextrose. 2 to 4 ml per kg of 25 dextrose, and you have to monitor to keep closing the monitoring of the RBS, because the effectiveness of dextrose or glucose will be dropped, and the acting or duration of sulfonylurea is prolonged up to 24 hours. Activate charcoal if the patient is present within first 2 hours, and if he is alert and not drowsy or comatose. Other second line, we have octreotide. We can give him 50 to 100 mic per continuously and every 6 hours. This patient need admission, of course, for monitoring of the RBS. What is the differential diagnosis if the patient present with the hypoglycemia, low blood sugar in the serum? Insulin, one of the differential diagnosis, and other of oral hypoglycemic agent. Ethanol also can cause hypoglycemia. Beta blocker. This is a beta blocker. We can distinguish from calcium channel blocker, but not necessarily present with it. Quinidine, which is class, which is class one antiarrhythmics, and endomethazine. This is a list of dangerous medication. As I mentioned, calcium channel blocker, tricyclic antidepressant, anti-malarious, opiate, and sulfonylurea, and class one antiarrhythmics. Remember, most of the children, they like to take a cocktail of medications. And don't think about only one medication. As I said in the previous or first case, he ingested multiple medications. So look for manifestations for such family. And also you can send the labs like paracetamol, aspirins, and others. So if you have unclear about how to approach them, you have to call the toxicologist. So this is the most common medication that causing death in US between 90 to the 2000, this bromine, which is antidepressant, and methadone, nifedipine, and diphenhydramine, morphine, and salicylate. So I will go fast because I have only 5 minutes. So this is a list of over-counter formulation and household products. So the most common one is camphor, and then only of wintergreen, liquid nicotine, and selenium dioxide. So in these medications, it's difficult to recognize or how to remember of the manifestations. So it's better to call a toxicologist and or referring for national poison book. So camphor, what is extracted from this tree, and it is used for as analgesic and irritation for itchiness, and used as cream or ointment. This is other product, and it is famous in our country and our society as fux. In Arabic, it's fux. So this is, I think most of you saw this. And the second one, oil of wintergreen, which is containing highly dose of methyl salicylate, and usually used for colds, headache, colic, and skin conditions. Liquid nicotine, which is used for electronic cigarette. It is a serious substance, and it is can cause death. If you are in doubt about any product, please call the toxicologist. He will guide you how to ask, which question you need to ask, and how to deal with such cases. So in summary, remember, one tablet of cardiac medication is serious and could be fatal. Calcium channel blocker, beta blocker, and digoxin. Always approach sick child with the ABCD two. So think about decontamination. And also I will add 2C, call toxicologist. They will, all of the our consultant toxicologists, they are helpful and kindful, and they are patient to for any inquiry or questions. Consider always remember to check RBS in comatose or any unresponsive child or any even adult. So always consider overdose as one differential.